Today, I'm going to show you how to create a classic tween and use a classic motion guide with it. So, I want you to open up the Snowball movie. This is the one that we created when I first showed you motion tween. Classic tween and motion tween are very similar. Remember with a motion tween, we created an object, and in this case, it was a snowball. We then converted that object to a symbol. You'll notice that the snowball is in the library. That means it's a symbol. Symbols can now be used to create motion tweens. We positioned our cursor where we wanted the snowball to end, inserted frames. After we inserted frames, they were gray, we right-clicked and we created a motion tween, which gave us blue, at which point we were able to drag our object to where we wanted it to end. You can move your tweening line by simply clicking on the line and dragging. So that's a review of your motion tween, which is a new thing in CS4 and beyond. Now I've locked all my layers, so I can't click on anything to change it. I want to protect these layers. I'm now going to create a new layer. In this layer, I'm going to call it hat. Let's draw a hat. I'm going to simply use my rectangle tool. And I'm going to my properties. I want to have a black hat. And I'm going to draw a rectangle. I'll just draw it over on the side. It doesn't quite matter. And draw another rectangle. If I want to change the size of this shape, don't forget that you have your free transform tool. If you select your object, let me go select my object first. There it is. Go to your free transform. You can resize or lengthen so you have a hat. So there I have a simple black hat. Feel free to add any kind of bling to your hat. You can use your brush tool. Right, that would be fine. I'm just going to change my color and do just another little. That's fine. Once you have your hat drawn, remember, just like with the motion tween, we need to convert this object into a symbol. So I'm going to use my selection arrow, highlight my object. To convert it to a symbol, F8. You could also go up to modify, convert to symbol. Call it what you want. And I'm going to create it as a graphic, and my registration point I'm going to keep in the center and hit OK. Notice that here is the hat that I just created. This hat was the one that we did in class. So there's my hat and there's my snowball. I just deleted the one that we're not using. All right, so I've got my hat. All right, I am ready to create a classic tween. The difference between a classic tween and a motion tween is with a classic tween, we use keyframes. So my hat is starting here. I want the hat to end up on my snowman over here. So in my frame, in this case it's 49, I'm going to insert a keyframe, but I want a filled keyframe. So I'm going to hit F6. This is the big difference between the motion tween and the classic tween. It copies the contents from frame 1 into frame, in this case, 49. Move the hat to where you want the hat to be. If you find that it is snapping to the grid, you can play with your snapping under the view menu and take off snap to grid. Okay. I have positioned my starting location, I positioned my end location, Simply click between the two points, the two keyframes, and choose Create a Classic Tween. Notice that I see a purple. Purple is for Classic Tween, where blue is for Motion Tween. And you will see when you run, the hat moves from point A to point B in a completely straight line. You've just created a Classic Tween. If you wanted to change locations, you can insert another keyframe and simply move the hat to a new location. So now notice that I have an angle on my hat, Classic Tween. I'm going to remove this keyframe, right click, clear the keyframe. It's gone. We're back to where we were before. Because instead, I now want to create a motion guide, a guide that goes with the hat. This way, I can draw any path and the hat will follow the path. So, go to your hat layer, right click, and choose Add Classic Motion Guide. You want to make sure that you see an arc. If you do not see the arc, delete it and do it again. Notice there is an empty keyframe. It is this empty keyframe that holds the path. What we're going to do now is draw the path. To draw the path, we use the pencil. You must pick a color that is not in your picture. So pick something very different. So I have no yellow, so let me pick a yellow. Let me switch up my colors. There we go. I want a yellow. I'm going to draw my starting location, and I'm going to start it approximately where I have that hat set. And notice how I can loop. There we go. Notice in my modifiers, I have chosen ink. So my pencil mode here, I like as ink. That way it can get really loopy. If I want to smooth that out, I can increase my smoothness. Now, here is the hard part. I've drawn my path. I want the hat to follow the path. So what I have to do is snap the hat at the beginning and snap the hat at the end using the keyframes in the hat layer. The guide layer only contains the path. Don't worry, when you play the movie, the guide disappears. Click on your first keyframe and notice I've pretty much gotten that snapped. So here it is. I can click on that circle and I have snapped it to the end. Okay. Go to the end and take your keyframe and snap it to the end. You can always adjust the location of this guide once you have it snapped. So there I have it, and I can, there we go, and I can continue to edit this. All right. And let's pull the hat up a little bit higher. Okay. I'm going to need to adjust my snowmen. Let's play our movie. Does it work? Look at how it is following the path. One more time. Notice it follow the path. But it doesn't look natural. So in order to make this look natural, in our property window, when we click on the first keyframe in the hat layer, notice what happens in your property window. Look under tweening. If tweening is not open, open it up. Orient to path. Now when we play our movie, do you notice how the hat moves around? You've done it. You've created a classic tween with a motion guide. Go ahead and you can play with that guide to make sure that that hat fits on the top of the head. Let's snap that. That looks pretty good. And we've got a flying hat. Done.